Hi, my name is Jens. Now I'll show you my new claw connector system. With this system, you can improve the landing rate with approximately 50% on all types of hard baits. Here you see an inline lure for sea trout, but it could also be a lot of other types of lures.
Det fedt smarte der. Det var efter det flere kast.
Here you see how it's mounted on an inline lure. It can also be mounted slightly different on a plated metal spoon or on a threaded metal spoon. Here you see how it's mounted on a crankbait. It could also have been a jerkbait or any other type of hard bait. So the claw connectors can be used practically on any lure for any species in the world in order to improve your landing rate, because you can use much smaller hooks that gives a better penetration and a more secure hook hold. Let me show you how to make these claw connectors. Here you see what you need to have in order to make the claw connector. You need to have stainless steel wire. This is 0.8, which is perfect for sea trout. 0.9 is a good choice for pike. You need tungsten beads in order to weight compensate the claw connector, because when you shift to a smaller hook, you need to have some beads in order to get the same weight as the original hook. If you're making claw connectors for inline lures, you need teardrop solid rings for like these. You need split rings. This is size 1, which is perfect for the sea trout, and for lighter pike lures, you might be using a size 2 for the larger pike lures. You need hooks. This I use the owner hooks. Size 12 is perfect choice for the sea trout. For the pike, it would be like a size 6 or 4. Then you need some tools in order to bend the claw connector. You need a flat nose plier. You need a round nose plier. You need a cutting plier in order to bite the wire clean off. And when you are going to mount the split rings on the hooks and the whole split ring plus hook on the claw connector, you also need split ring pliers, and you need split ring pliers with a small slim beak and a small tooth at the end. This is the owner version, and this is the Savage gear. Now I'll show you exactly how to make the claw connector. You take a piece of stainless steel wire. For the sea trout was 0.8, and you hold it with the round nose plier and make a small bend like this. And you hold it again with the plier and twist the wire around with your fingers, so you have the start of an eye, and you will do like this to fulfill the form of the eye. You see now it was a little bit twisted the wrong way. Then I take the flat nose plier and force it down into a position. So now you have the start of the eye. Now I'll show you exactly how to close the eye by holding the eye with the flat nose plier and taking a firm grip, tight grip, and then simply twist it round like this. Then you have the eye. Then you take a cutting plier like this one. This is the Savage gear cutting plier, it's really good for the purpose. Cut it tight. And you have the eye ready. If you want to make it real nice, you can take a metal file and just file the edge, so there's no sharp edges on it. Okay, so now you have the eye ready. Then you put on the tungsten bead on the wire, so it's on like this. I have a slotted bead, a slotted tungsten bead, because it slides a bit easier on a curved connector. And then you're going to make the first bend. And the angle you are going to make the bend in depends on whether you're going to use it on an inline lure for sea trout or a plated lure. For inline lure, you are going to have the two eyes in the same plane. In this case, you'll start to make the bend like this. In order to make them in the same length, it's good to have a ruler so you can see how many centimeters you bend. And for sea trout, if the end of the eye is at 0, you start to make the bend at 1.5. centimeters, and you are going to make the eye in the same plane, so you're going to turn the eye like this, so you will be making the bend in the same direction as the first eye. So now you simply make the bend just as before by doing like this, so it looks like this, and then you bend the second eye in exactly the same way as the first eye. So now we have been bending the first eye. we put it on a tungsten bead. And now we are going to take this teardrop shaped solid ring from Savage Gear to mount into the next eye. When you're fishing inliner, this is quite important to steer the cloakator correctly, so the hook turns the right way in the water. This is very important to maximize the landing rate, but I'll show you later. Now I'll first show you how to incorporate this solid ring into the claw connector. So now I'm going to show you how to incorporate the teardrop shaped solid ring into the claw connector. You take it onto the wire and slide it down to where you're going to make the eye. And you hold it like this. So now we're going to make the bend just like before. Just do like this. But before you are closing the eye completely, you must of course be sure that the ring is inside the eye, not outside the eye. So you hold it like this. And then you finish the eye the same way as you did before, by doing like this. And then closing the eye. So now I'll take the flat nose plier and hold the eye with the ring inside, and then I simply close the eye the same way as I did before, with a firm grip and a tight twisting like this. So now we have closed the eye. All we need to do is take the cutting plier and bite it off like this. Now we are almost ready with the claw connector for inline lures. So here you see that the claw connector for inline lures is almost ready. We have the first eye, the wire, the tungsten bead, second eye, and inside the second eye we have the teardrop shaped solid ring. And this teardrop shaped solid ring is going to fit into a special bead here called the claw connector bead. And this bead makes several purposes. The first thing is that it steers the claw connector in the right way, so you will be having one branch turning away from the lure and two branching pointing up against the lure. And that is very important, because when the hook is turned this way, it gives a higher landing rate, because you get 100% depth of hook grip, and at the same time you maximize the chance of only hooking on one branch, and this gives a better penetration and a better hook hold. So the purpose is to steer the hook right, but also to offset the hook a little bit from the longitudinal axis in order to create a better general hook exposure. Here I can show you the bead. When you see the bead from this angle, you can see that it has got like a long slim channel of a hole that fits the shape of the teardrop ring exactly. So when you push it in there, it stays there, but as soon as you get a fish on, it will be shaken out, so the lure and the bead can run up the line while you fight the fish. But let me show you how to bend the claw connector so it gets this shape. Okay, so now we are going to bend the claw connector so it gets the curved shape, and you hold it with a round nose plier like this, and then you simply bend it with your fingers a little bit, and you do it in both ends and in the middle. See, now it's got the right shape. So here you can see how the claw connector is going to turn in the water when you're fishing. You see, I have the lure here, and only one branch is pointing in the direction of the movement of the lure. And this is very important, as I said before, because this optimizes the chance that only one hook point will be hitting on the jaw. And this means that you get the maximum depth of hook grip, and you get an easier penetration, because one branch penetrates easier than two or three. So it's going to ride like this in the water, so it's very important that you turn the hook right in the claw connector when you're going to mount it. And I'll show you that in details later. Another reason why it's important to have this curve is that when you have this curve, it is not only helping to get a better exposure of the hook and turning the hook right in the water, it's also important because it helps getting the small hook down behind the jaw. And the reason why this is important is that on the lower part of the inner jaw, you get a thicker, soft tissue, but it's easier for the hook to get a grip compared to the on the upper inner side of the jaw. So that's another purpose of the shape of the claw connector. So here you see how the claw connector can be used on different types of sea trout lures. It can be used on the inliner, as we described before. It can be used on a traditional plated spoon. It can be used on a threaded spoon with a thread eye. And it can be used on a completely normal spinner, as this one, where you mount it in the wire eye in the end. As you can see on all of these, it is turned so that one branch is turning away from the lure and two branches are turning up against the lure. The main difference between the claw connector for the inline lures and for the plated or threaded lures is that here on the latter, the claw connector, the eye on the claw connector is turning 90 degrees to each other, and this is important to create the right angle so we get the right exposure of the hook and we optimize for the chance of hooking on just one branch. So the main difference between the inline version and the one for fixed eyes is that the two eyes on the claw connector are 90 degrees to each other. And it is mounted on a lure, very simple, with a split ring. On the contrary to the inline version where it's mounted, it's tied to the line inside the bead. When you're fishing with plated lures, it's important that you turn the claw connector right relatively to the shape of the lure. Most plated spoons are curved like you see here from this angle. And so when it's curved like this, when the curve on the lure is turning down, the claw connector is going to turn like this in order to get the right exposure and grip of the hook when the fish bites. So you could say that the curve of the lure should be going the opposite way of the curve of the connector. So the lure plus the connector creates the shape of an S, like you can see here. This is how to do it on the plated spoon. Now I'll show you how to do it on a threaded spoon. When you have a threaded molded lure like this one, you normally have one side which is heavier than the other one. And as you can see here, now that one side which is the heavy one is turning down. And when the lure is turning like this, you're going to turn the connector so it's turned like you see it here. And as you can see, the connector for this type of lure, it is also a connector where the two eyes are 90 degrees to each other. Before you're going to mount the treble in the split ring, you need to be able to learn and tell the difference between the three branches on a treble. On this type of treble, which is a Y treble, this is an owner hook, you want to have the hook gape or the hook branch, which is parallel to the eye, to be turning in the forward moving direction. And this is also the branch that you want to having pointing away from the lure when you're fishing in order to get the right onshearing of the hook. The reason why this type of treble is called a Y treble is that when seen from above, it looks like a Y. The other type of treble is called a T treble, and on this type of treble, the eye will be standing 90 degrees to what you see here. But let me show you how you mount the treble correctly in the split ring so that one branch and the right branch like this is pointing in the forward direction and away from the lure. So when you are going to mount the hook, you first hold the split ring like this and you take the very narrow split ring plier like this one from Savage Gear and you open it. So you click it down on here, and now it's very important that you have this very slim plier, because that is easier to get the ring on, because you can rotate it like this while you put the ring on. Let me show you now how to put it on the claw connector. So now I hold the split ring in the plier where it's semi-open like this. And you see, I want it to turn like this when it sits on the lure. So one branch is in the forward direction of movement on the lure. So what you do is that you hold the claw connector like this. Click the split ring in. And with the slim plier, you rotate the split ring on, like this, and then it sits with the one branch pointing in the right direction. And now we are actually ready to mount it on the inline lure. And we're doing this by putting the line through the lure, putting the line through the chlorinator bead, tying it here, cutting the snip off, and then you're ready to go. So what you do when you are going to mount the chlorinator on the inliner is that you thread the inliner, the trace, like this. Then you take the chlorinator bead and you take the trace through the narrow end of the chlorinator bead. So as you can see here, the outgoing hole of the chlorinator bead is shaped like a narrow slot. And this narrow slot fits just perfect for the solid ring here. So it fits straight down into the slot, so it's semi-fixed. Now I'll just show you how to tie the trace on the solder ring. You put it like this and tie it to the narrow end of the teardrop shaped solder ring. And you use a grinner knot like this. It's also called a uni knot. Take it off from here. Four times through. And the last time here. Like this. Then you moist it. Tighten the knot. Like this. Tighten it up. Also tighten contra in this tag here. Like this. And you just simply bite off the, or cut off the tag with a sharp scissor. And then we are ready to mount the whole thing. You hold it like this and you stick the knot in. And you drag with the pull of the line here, the solid ring in. So it sits perfectly semi-fixed inside the bead like this. This is how it's riding in the water, with the claw pointing down and one branch pointing away from the lure, so this is perfect. And when you get a bite, the teardrop solid ring will pull out of the bead, and then the bead and the lure can start up the line, so you avoid any leverage from the lure.
Så, det er perfekt. Skide godt.
På klovkonnektoren.
Perfekt. Det er skide godt, Martin.
Det er rigtig fedt, det her.
Perfekt.
Det fungerer altså bare, Jens.
Lad os se at fange nogle flere.
Oh yes.
Here you see how the claw connector is used on a hard bait for example, pike. And as you can see here, when the eye on the bait is turned like this, you need a claw connector where the two eyes are lying in the same spatial plane, as you can see here, in order to get the right on searing of the hook when you connect with the split ring. And what you want, as I've said earlier, is that you want to have one branch pointing away from the lure and two branches pointing up against the lure, because this gives a deeper hook grip and it also gives a better penetration, because you maximize the chance of just hooking on one branch, and one branch penetrates easier than two or three branches. And it's also better for the fish only to get hooked on one branch. So this is how it looks when you are mounting your chlorinators on a hard bait. On some hard baits, the end eye would be turning, standing 90 degrees to this one. In that case, with this type of hook, you would be turning this eye on the claw connector 90 degrees to what you see here. So, in order to get the right on shearing of the hook in the water. It is also possible to use other types of hooks than the owner hook. On this type of hook, like the owner, only one branch is parallel to the eye. On this type of hook, like the Y triple here, one branch is parallel to the eye, as you can see. You also have another type of a triple called a T triple, and on this type, none of the branches are parallel to the eye, but one of the branches is 90 degrees to the eye. If you have this type of treble, you can also use the claw connector system. You would just be using a claw connector where the two eyes are standing 90 degrees to each other in order to mount it in an eye that stands like this. So You can use the claw collection system with all hooks and on all baits as long as you think of how the angles on the eye and the connector is, so you obtain this orientation of the hook in the water you see here, with one branch pointing away from the lure and two branches pointing up against the lure. So now we're ready to fish. Good luck with your claw connector fishing. It will give you a lot more fish. On average, it will give you an improvement in the length reach of around 50% on a bait like this, compared to the normal big hooks.